Hi, I'm Terry from Crosse Technology, and this is the WS-7014 weather station. When you open the package, you'll find three parts. We have the station itself, the stand, and the outdoor sensor. First thing we will do is get our outdoor sensor ready to go. Very simple. We simply push the battery door downwards, and we put a pair of fresh alkaline batteries into the unit. Once those are in, we're going to move this about 3 to 5 feet away for normal setup. Okay, the next step is to put batteries into the weather station itself. This battery door opens by lifting from the bottom up, and we put a pair of fresh alkaline batteries in here. And you'll notice that the system comes up fairly quickly. And we'll wait for it a couple of seconds, and it's picked up the outdoor temperature. We have an indoor temperature showing of 79.3 with 48% humidity, and you'll notice he's frowning because 48% humidity is a little too low for comfort levels. When the temperature and humidity are within normal comfort levels, the frowny face moves up and is a happy face. In the center we have a forecast icon. It's a standard 3-icon forecast showing what we expect the weather to be in the next 12 to 18 hours. Above that is the date and the time. We're going to put the stand on here real quickly. To put this stand on, put the front in, and it just snaps. To set the unit up, we push the set button and hold it. The time will turn into the letters LCD and a flashing number. The flashing number can be changed to give a more or less dense display. Pressing the set button again gives us our time zone. This is set for -5H, which is East Coast time, which is where all of our weather stations set up as their standard. What we're going to do is use the in button, set it to -4H. We're now in Atlantic time, and we can run all the way around the world. And we're going to stop when we get to -8H, which puts us in California West Coast time. Pressing and releasing the set button again shows us daylight savings time mode. A flashing one means that we're set up for daylight savings time. If we want, we can press the in button, take it to zero, and now it will not recognize daylight savings time. The West Coast does, so we'll take it to one. Pressing set once again, RCC, radio controlled clock, we want that on. That allows the clock to receive the signal from Fort Collins, Colorado, and automatically set the time, the date, the day, and the daylight savings time mode. Pressing the set button again gives us the option of 12 or 24 hour clock, and that changes with the in button. Notice when we go to 24 hour clock, our date is displayed differently. Instead of month and day, it goes to day and month. Pressing set again allows us to set the time if we wish. Pressing the plus button, setting the hour, and the out button, setting the minute. Press set once again, we can set our year, the in button, each click 1 year. After our year, we press set once again, our date is flashing. Pressing the in button changes the month, and pressing the out button changes the day of the month. Pressing set once again gives us a 10. That 10 is standard in the system and does not need to be changed. Pressing set one more time shows us we're in degrees Fahrenheit. Pressing the in button lets us take it to Celsius if we wish. We're going to take it back to Fahrenheit. Pressing set one more time shows us the forecast sensitivity. And for most applications, leaving that at 2 is correct. If you live in the mountains or on the coasts, your owner's manual will show you how to change that. Pressing the set button one more time, and the system is set up and ready to operate. One interesting feature about this station is the channel button. You can run up to 3 different sensors on this unit, and those sensors are controlled in by the channel button. All of the sensors should be modeled TX29, and you can use a sensor to check the outdoor temperature, the temperature in the garage, and perhaps the temperature in one of the other bedrooms.